Hi viewers, welcome to my channel Go Loop Audio. Today I'm looking at replacing the headband on my trusty Sennheiser HD 280 Pro headphones. I've had these for many years, but unfortunately, as you can see, the headband has been fraying slightly, so all the plastic's coming off, it gets in the hair. So it's time to replace them. So let's have a look at doing that. So what I bought is this replacement headband. You can get these cheap online. I bought this one from eBay for about £3. So I thought I'd give it a go and replace the original and see how it goes. Right, the first thing we need to do is take off the previous headband. And it looks like it's kind of moved out of position. It should be about here, to be honest. But it's sort of slipped over the ears. As I say, I've had these for about 10 years. So let's see if I can just take this off. And see how it comes apart. It looks like this top piece is wrapped in. Ah, there we go. That came off pretty easily. I'll just take that out. There we go. There's the old headband. And that was pretty easy to take off. As you can see, it's kind of got a runner in there. So it was kind of half clipped in, but coming away. As you can see, it's broken off there as well. Right. I'm probably just going to clean this up a minute before I do the next bit. Okay, so I've just given them a bit of a wipe with a damp cloth. There's no like residual glue or anything to clean off. So yeah, that seems to have done the job. I'm not super tidy, but that's good enough for me. So here we have the replacement band. Let's just take this out of the packet. So it's got a nice soft cushion and looks like it's got the same runner. So I'm trying to work out which bit clips onto which, but I presume this on the left is the inner bit. And this on the right is the bit that clips into it. Let's just try that. Yeah, that seems to be the way. This looks kind of like a hooking mechanism. So I presume what will happen is it will be really tight. And then once you hook that over, it should stay in place. So, well, let's give that a go. Let's just put the pad over and let's just put the left hand piece over first. Let's try and get it over the center and then let's see if we can hook over the right hand piece. Okay, well, it seems to have hooked over and then latched itself on. It's not very much in the center, but it looks okay for now. I'll probably just readjust that and just try and get it centered. Okay, so I gave that another go. It literally just took one more go. I centered it a bit more. It's a little bit off to the right, but I'm really not that fussy. That seems to have done the job, so there we go. Compared to the old flaking headband, this is definitely an upgrade. You can also see the ear cups here, they're starting to sort of fray a bit, so let me know in the comments if you want me to show you how to replace these, but for now, they work for me, and they're not really sort of fraying too much, so there you go. Replacing the headband on the Sennheiser HD 280 Pro headphones. It's as simple as that. So for the viewers that watched the last episode, will know that I ordered a Zoom H4n Pro and unboxed it in the video. Unfortunately, there was some problem with missing vertical lines of pixels on the screen. So in the end, just to update you, I did send that back to Guitar Amp Keyboard in Brighton. They were very kind. They replaced it immediately. They sent me a free returns label, so I packaged it up, sent it back, and I now have a replacement. So we're just going to quickly unbox that and check everything's okay. Okay, so here we are. A new parcel has been sent to me. Here we go. All wrapped up. And some packaging tape. See if we can fight our way into the box itself. Well, they've done well on the packaging, kept it nice and safe. Okay, so here's the replacement that they've sent me. I'll just check the box. Last time the box had a rip in it, so I think maybe it's been dropped on the warehouse floor or something before sending out to me. But this looks absolutely brand new, great condition. Let's just open it up here. Okay, yep, this all looks good. So we've got the Zoom handy recorder. If you remember from the last video, there's just a bunch of manuals in the bottom of that box there, and that's pretty much all that you get. So you have to get all the accessories yourself. And let's have a look. Okay, that looks good. Let's just put in the SD card here. Right, let's just plug in the power supply. If I remember from last time, I think I just rock this over. And that should boot it up. So here we go. It's version 1.1. Now loading, I have inserted the SD card there, so it should detect it. The recording from last time should be on there. Okay, so there we go. It says the SD card has 12 hours of recording. Maybe we can go into the menu. So I remember going to the recording settings, and I like to change the format to 48 kHz and 24-bit. Press menu to go back up. And again. So there we are. Now it says 7 hours of recording. That's what it said last time. And
okay, well, we can see the time moving now, so I guess that means we're actually recording.
Okay, I just pressed play, and that was actually the recording from last week, because on the back of the Zoom, there is this little speaker. And it's just so you can check, you know, the audio that you're recording, and, you know, just to check it. It's okay. It's not a very good speaker, but it's very useful. So there we go. We've got the replacement Zoom H4n Pro. It seems to be working fine. And we've also got the headphones repaired and ready to use, so I can monitor my recordings. So the next thing I'm going to do is order a lav mic that I'm going to use when I'm doing voiceovers. And I'm just going to plug it into the back here. Because as you heard last week, the recording from the stereo mics isn't really appropriate for doing voiceovers. So I've got that on order. So maybe we'll see that in the next episode. Hope to see you there.